Alhamdulillah, wa kafa wa salatu wa salamu ala ibadihi alladhina istafa amma ba'd. Respected ulama ikram, elders, beloved brothers in Islam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has made this insan, this human being such, that what he sees, what he hears, what he speaks about, what he comprehends, causes an inner conviction. The Arabic term for it is yaqeen, to be formed within himself. And like a car uses fuel, and with the fuel it is driven in a certain direction, likewise this yaqeen, this conviction that is developed within this insan and human being drives him in a certain direction. If what he sees, what he hears, what he comprehends is incorrect, then accordingly that inner conviction will drive him in the incorrect direction. This is the mafhum and meaning of the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, wherein he said, وَإِنَّ فِي الْجَسَدِ لَمُضْغَةٍ إِذَا صَلُحَتْ صَلُحَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ وَإِذَا فَسَدَتْ فَسَدَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّهُ أَلَا وَهِيَ الْقَلْبُ أَلَا وَهِيَ الْقَلْبُ أَلَا وَهِيَ الْقَلْبُ. But Allah's Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that in the body is a piece of flesh. If this piece of flesh is correct, then the a'mal and the actions that emanate from every limb of the body of this person will be correct. And if this piece of flesh is incorrect, then from every limb of the body of this person, whichever robe he may adorn in society, as a father, zulm and fasad he will spread. As a husband, he will be a zalim. As a businessman, he will be a zalim. As a lawyer, he will be a zalim. Whichever facet of society he may occupy, if this piece of flesh is incorrect, Allah's Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, فَسَدَ الْجَسَدُ كُلُّ. From every limb of the body of this person, fasad and zulm will spread. And then three times Allah's Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam reiterated, he said, أَلَا وَهِيَ الْقَلْبُ أَلَا وَهِيَ الْقَلْبُ أَلَا وَهِيَ الْقَلْبُ. That listen, it is the heart. Listen, it is the heart. Listen, it is the heart. In other words, the yaqeen and the conviction of the heart. We are living in a society today where from every direction and at every point, from infancy to adulthood, till the person becomes an old person, whether it is the school, whether it is the university, whether it is the media, whether it is the literature, every direction there is one propaganda, one voice, one awaz that is being made, that paisa ho to kaam banega. That if you have wealth, you have everything. All your problems will be solved. You will get respect, you will get dignity, you will get honor. People will look up to you. Your goal and your purpose in this world is acquire wealth. Whatever need or requirement you have, through wealth and through money you will be able to fulfill it. When this is the conviction in a person, and for that person to bring his life onto Shariat, and for that person to bring his life onto the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, my respected brothers, is impossible. First, this conviction has to be corrected. And what is the correct conviction? That Allah is everything. That whatever problems you have, the solver of every problem is Allah. Whatever you desire, whatever you want in the world, it is in the hands of Allah. You want respect, تُعِزُّ مَن تَشَاءُ وَلِلَّهِ الْعِزَّةُ وَلِرَسُولِهِ وَلِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ. It is in the hands of Allah. You want wealth, يَبْسُطُ الرِّزْقَ لِمَن يَشَاءُ. It is in the hands of Allah. You want superiority, you want to be recognized, وَأَنْتُمُ الْعَالَوْنَ إِن كُنْتُم مُؤْمِنِينَ. That also is in the hands of Allah. You want help, nusrat of Allah Ta'ala, وَكَانَ حَقًّا عَلَيْنَا نَصْرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. It is in the hands of Allah. You want a pure life, you want a chaste life in this world. مَنْ عَمِلَ صَالِحًا مِنْ ذَكَرٍ أُنْثَى وَهُوَ مُؤْمِنٌ فَلَنُحْيِيَنَّهُ حَيَاةً طَيِّبًا. You want love, you want recognition, you want acceptance from the people. سَيَجْعَلُ لَهُمُ الرَّحْمَنُ وُدًّا. That is also in the hands of Allah. You want barakat and blessings in life. وَلَوْ أَنَّ أَهْلَ الْقُرَىٰ
آمنوا واتقوا لفتحنا عليهم بركات من السماء والأرض. It is in the hands of Allah. You want your problems to be solved. وَمَنْ يَتَّقِ اللَّهِ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا وَيَرْزُقْهُ مِنْ حَيْثُ لَا يَحْتَسِبْ. That is also in the hands of Allah. The only door is Allah. Allah sometimes does with the world. Allah Ta'ala sometimes does without the world. But the door is Allah. Wealth, mal is a sabab, it is a means. This conviction that Allah is everything, my respected brothers, this constituted the fundamental, primary effort of every Nabi of Allah. First and foremost, to correct the yaqeen and conviction in the heart of this insan. Because there is only one bunyad and one foundation that is correct, and that is this bunyad and foundation. And if this insan is to come onto this, where Allah becomes the goal, Allah is the direction, the qibla, and rukh of his heart is only Allah. That I have to please my Allah, and I have to come unto that which my Allah wants, and in fulfilling the commands of my Allah, everything can go. Everything can go, but I will not break the command of Allah. When this conviction is found, then no force of batin in this world will ever shake this person. We see, with our pious predecessors of the past, even prior to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, those that were firm on this, whatever obstacle came in front of them, حُمِّلُوا عَلَى الْأَخْشَابِ, they were crucified, but they did not deter. نُشِّرُوا بِالْمَنَاشِيرِ, swords were used to saw their bodies into two pieces, yet they remained firm. وَيُمْشَتُ بِأَمْشَاتِ الْحَدِيدِ مَا دُونَ لَحْمِهِ وَإِظَامِهِ. Some of them, living human beings, metal rods were used to separate the flesh from the bones of their bodies. This also they bore, but they did not move away from that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted. Why? Because the inner conviction was correct. That conviction which is prevailing today in society, that wealth is everything, when that is the conviction, then my respected brothers, riba will become halal for us. To lie and cheat also will become okay. To usurp the rights of others will be okay. To trample upon the hukuk of others will be okay. Why? Because the goal and the object is wealth. How I get it is not of any concern to me. Like the hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where he said, يَأْتِي عَلَى النَّاسِ زَمَانٌ لَا يُبَالِ الْمَرْءُ مَا أَخَذَ أَمِنَ الْحَلَالِ أَمِنَ الْحَرَامِ. He said, a time will come upon humanity that people will not care where the wealth is coming from. As long as the coffers have been filled, wealth will become everything. Mal will become everything. And the drive for that will blind humanity to such an extent. Amin al-halal, amin al-haram. Whether it is halal or haram will be academic. It will be of no interest to them whatsoever. Like one businessman, he met me, he says, Mauli Sahab, be realistic. If we don't take loans and interest from the bank, how are we going to keep up with the competition? How are we going to keep up with the other competitors in business if we don't take these loans and interest? Ask ourselves the question, my respected brothers. This individual with this type of yaqeen, how is his life ever going to come onto Sharia? How is he ever going to be prepared to sacrifice for the taqazas and the requisites and the requirements of the effort of deen when he is prepared to challenge Allah and say to Allah that you say interest is haram, but I say, as long as I don't involve myself in this, my livelihood needs cannot be met. This mindset, this thinking, my respected brothers, is not there only amongst the rich, it's even amongst the poor. The poor man also says, with those paltry earnings he has, those few coins he has, what he does, he goes and buys the lottery ticket. And then he says, make dua that my number comes. Then I must be successful. Ulama say, this conviction that wealth is everything, they say is a kufr conviction. It is a conviction of batil. It is a conviction that will make it halal to get involved in interest, usurping the rights of others, falsifying documents, court cases fought year upon year, when in the heart the person knows he is doing somebody else down. Women, sisters, mothers, done down of their inheritance. all sorts of haram, so far as livelihood is taking place under this banner, under this title, that wealth is everything. A person with this type of conviction, my respected brothers, he will make namaz also and he'll still do other people down. He'll go for hajj, he'll go for umrah upon umrah, he'll fast in the month of Ramadan and he'll still make zulm on others. He'll give sadaqah and charity, put up masjids and put up madrasas and feed the poor and still steal from others. First, this conviction has to be corrected. That Allah is everything. When I didn't exist, the one who put the system of livelihood, Allah. Whilst I am existing, everything around me, whether it is the shop or the job or the degree, is just a smoke screen. The door is one Allah alone. And after I die and leave this world, then it is still the Raj and the kingdom and the system of Allah that will prevail. Whatever is found in this world is coming from the treasures of my Allah. وَإِن مِّن شَيْءٍ إِلَّا عِنْدَنَا خَزَائِنُهُ وَمَا نُنَزِّلُهُ إِلَّا بِقَدَرٍ مَعْلُومٍ وَلِلَّهِ خَزَائِنُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. The treasures of the heavens and the earth belong to one Allah alone. And what treasures? Limitless treasures. Hadith Qudsi, Allah's Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam narrates the words of Allah, Ya ibadi, law anna awwalakum wa akhirakum, wa insakum wa jinnakum, wa hayyakum wa mayyitakum, wa ratbakum wa yabisakum, qamu fi sa'idin wahidin, fasa'aluni, fa'ataytu kulla insanin mas'alata. Allah says, O my slaves, if the first and the last amongst you, if every insan, every jinnat, every human being from Adam alayhi salam till today and to come till Qiyamah, every jinnat, every living, every dead, every green, every dry, every fresh, every withered, all are together on one plane. And all of you at one time has to place your needs before Allah. Leave needs. Not zaruriyat, khayishat. Beyond needs, place your desires before Allah. At one time, look at the kamal of my Allah. More than 6 billion insans speaking at one time. Someone shouting, someone whispering. Different dialects, different intonations, different modes of expression, different languages. Some are deaf and dumb. Their hearts are speaking. At one time, يَسْمَعُ ذَجِيجَهُمْ بِاخْتِلَافِ لُغَاتِهِمْ وَلَهْجَاتِهِمْ لَا تُغَلِّتُهُ كَثْرَةُ الْمَسَائِلِ لَا يَمْنَعُهُ فَضْلٌ عَنْ فَضْلٌ وَلَا يُلْهِيهِ قَوْلٌ عَنْ قَوْلٌ. The most populous country of the world today, India. India alone, they say there are 360 different languages. In the world, they estimate 6,000 different languages, all at one time. Allah will listen to each one individually. The different dialects, intonation and languages of this multitude of creation will not confuse Allah as to what each one is asking. And if Allah Ta'ala has to grant every one of them whatever they ask, and beyond that, ما نقص ذلك مما عندي إلا كما ينقص المخية إذا أدخل البحر. Janabi Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam says that Allah says that this will not diminish from my creation, from my treasures, not that much. You take a pin, poke it into the ocean, lift it up. That pin, to some extent, has diminished from the water of the oceans, fulfilling the desires of every insan and every jinnat, even to that extent, will not diminish from the treasures of one Allah. Like the poet says, لَا تَخْضَعَنَّ لِمَخْلُوقٍ عَلَىٰ طَمَعٍ لَا تَخْضَعَنَّ لِمَخْلُوقٍ عَلَىٰ طَمَعٍ فَإِنَّ ذَلِكَ مُذِرٌ مِّنْكَ بِالدِّينِ وَاسْتَرْزِقِ اللَّهِ وَاسْتَرْزِقِ اللَّهِ مِمَّا فِي خَزَائِنِهِ فَإِنَّمَا هِيَ بَيْنَ الْكَافِ وَالنُّونِ. He says, do not belittle yourself. Do not lower yourself. Do not demean yourself by looking at the makhluq. By turning towards the disobedience of Allah. By putting your gaze on the pockets of others, this will harm your deen. وَاسْتَرْزِقِ اللَّهِ. Turn to your Allah. Look at the khazana and treasures of your Allah. Why? إِنَّمَا هِيَ بَيْنَ الْكَافِ وَالنُّونَ. Your Allah's khazana is such. اُسْكَ عَمَرْ. كُنْ كَهْنَكِ بِزَرُورَتْ نَهِ. Allah ka irada wujud hai. Allah's intention is existence. Not even, Allah doesn't need to say kun also. Amruhu bain al kafi wa noon. Allah's affair is between the kaf and the noon. Whatever you want, 10 times this dunya, 100 times this dunya, million times this dunya, kun fayakun. For Allah it is nothing. That businessman or that individual with this conviction in his heart, if he will go into the marketplace, whatever temptation is there in front, he will never go towards haram. Why? He will say, الرزق على الله. My sustenance is coming from my Allah. وَمَا مِن دَابَّةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ إِلَّا عَلَى اللَّهِ رِزْقُهَا. My Allah has taken it upon himself. What is due to me will come to me. I do not have to go towards haram. Of all the sifat and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the most difficult sifat and attribute to bring conviction and yaqeen upon, my respected brothers, is the sifat and attribute that Allah is Rabb. Allah is the sustainer. Allah is the nourisher. Allah is the provider. Allah is Khaliq. Allah is the creator. Ask someone, by who created the sun? Easily they say Allah. Who created the moon? Allah. Who created the earth? Allah. Who created the winds? Allah. By who is sustaining you? They'll say Allah, but the but comes in. My effort, my intelligence, my know-how, I have to sign that document, I have to do that little bit behind the scenes work, then only it'll come. That I and that but is where the door of shirk opens. And if I find, my respected brothers, in alam-e arwah, Allah did not ask about any other sifat. Allah did not say, Alastu khaliqikum. Allah did not ask, am I not your creator? Allah did not ask, am I not the one who has given you life? What question was asked? Alastu bi rabbikum. Am I not your Rabb? There in one voice everyone said, Bala, ya Allah, you are our Rabb. When you came into this dunya, Allah sent His Quran. When Allah starts His Quran, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. When Allah completes His Quran, قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ. Start the Quran, Allah says, I am your Rabb. Finish the Quran, Allah says, I am your Rabb. In between the Quran, Allah says, إِنَّ رَبَّكُمُ اللَّهِ الَّذِي خَلَقَ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ فِي سِتَّةِ أَيَّامِ ثُمَّ اسْتَوَى عَلَى الْعَرْشِ يُغْشِ اللَّيْلَ النَّهَارِ يَطْلُبُهُ حَثِيثًا وَالشَّمْسِ وَالْقَمَرِ وَالنُّجُومِ مُسَخَّرَاتٍ بِأَمْرِهِ أَلَا لَهُ الْخَلْقُ وَالْأَمْرِ تَبَارَكَ اللَّهِ رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ ذَلِكُمُ اللَّهِ رَبُّكُمُ الْحَقِّ. Start the Quran, Allah is Rabb. Finish the Quran, Allah is Rabb. In between the Quran again and again, Allah is Rabb. Allah is Rabb. Allah is Rabb. Start your salah. Go into ruku. Subhana Rabbi al-Azim. Stand up in Qoma. Rabbana laka alhamd. Go into sajda. Subhana Rabbi al-A'la. Every posture of salah, Allah is reminding you. Say it over and over again. Allah is my Rabb. Allah is my Rabb. Allah is my Rabb. Because when you go into the qabr, it will not be asked that in Glennon Road Masjid, who used to make sajda to? Even the greatest bay namazi who doesn't even go for Eid namaz, no one will say that I used to make sajda to anyone else besides Allah. But the question there will not be about your namaz. There the question will be, Mar Rabbuk? Who was your Rabb? Those who ate up the inheritance of their mothers and sisters. Those who signed those big, big interest documents. Those who usurped the rights of others, falsified documents, went towards haram and ate up the haq hukuk of others. Illa mashallah, ask ourselves the question, my respected brothers, how are they going to answer that Rabbi Allah, that my Rabbi is Allah? Take a cassette and put it, a music cassette, put it into a tape recorder and press play. Qiraat will not come out, music will come out. What is inside is what the answer is going to be. We were given this period to prepare ourselves. Anbiya alayhimus salatu wassalam. This was the first effort to instill this correct yaqeen that Allah is everything. The beloved daughter of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Fatima radiallahu anha, she comes in front of her father, Imran bin Hussein radiallahu ta'ala, who is the narrator of the hadith. He says she was on the verge of starvation. قَدْ ذَهَبَ عَنْ وَجْهِهَا أَثْرَ الدَّمْ.
The color of blood had left her face. Her pallor was deathly yellow. Her cheeks had become yellow. Sahaba were at his beck and call. This was that jamaat that would address him, Nafdika bi abaina wa ummahatina. What does this mean? They would address him like this, that, oh, our beloved master, may our parents be sacrificed upon you. Command us, we are ready to carry out your command. That is how they would address Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They are there, at his behest. His daughter is on the verge of starvation. He does not request any sahabi for anything. What does he do? Even at this critical juncture, he teaches this ummat yaqeen. He looks towards the heavens. Ya mushbi al ja'a, wa ya qadi al haja, wa ya rafi al wada'a, la tuji' Fatimata binti Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He says, oh my Allah, you are the one that satisfies those who are hungry. You don't need food for this. Oh my Allah, you are the one who raises those who are downtrodden. Oh my Allah, you are the one that fulfills the needs of those who are in need. Take away the hunger of the daughter of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. There and then, without any food, her cheeks started glowing with health. The blood rushed back. Many years later, someone asked her, Fatima, what was the effect of this dua of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? She says, from that day onwards, whether I ate or I did not eat, I never experienced hunger again. This ummah was taught yaqeen. Everything around us, the multitudes of Allah's creation. Spiders alone, there are 10,000 different species of spiders. That ant in its hole, the queen ant lays 30,000 eggs. In the oceans, how many vast multitudes of Allah's creation? Who is sustaining all this? Who is providing for them? Does that Allah who is providing for all these creations require you to go towards haram? Does Allah require you to lie for Him to give you your 2 pieces of roti? Does Allah require you to go to that bank and lower yourself before that ghair qawm Nasara and sign a document where you declare war with Allah for Him to put food on your plate? That Allah who is sustaining such a vast multitude of His creation. Musa alayhi salam one day is walking. Allah commands him. He passes by a rock. Allah says, strike the rock. He strikes the rock with his staff. It opens up. Strike it again. It opens up. Strike it again. It opens up. 3 layers inside. What is there? One insect with a blade of grass in its mouth. Allah commands him, Musa, put your ears near. He puts his ears near. And he listens to what that insect is saying. Subhana man yarani. Subhana man yarani. يَعْرِفُ مَكَانِي يَرْزُقُنِي وَلَا يَنْسَانِي. Glory be to my Allah who is looking at me in 3 layers of rock. Knows what my needs are. يَرْزُقُنِي وَلَا يَنْسَانِي. Is sustaining me and has not forgotten me. وَكَأَيِّمْ مِنْ دَابَّةِ اللَّا تَحْمِلُ رِزْقَهَا اللَّهُ يَرْزُقُهَا وَإِيَّاكُمْ وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Allah says in the Quran, look around you. Which animal do you see carrying its food for tomorrow? That animal with its minimal intellect has this conviction that the Allah who sustained me today will sustain me tomorrow. Insan, your intelligence is supposed to be more. On one occasion, Allah's Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam dispatched a jamaat of sahaba, 400 sahaba in the path of Allah. It was a time of faqa, of want in Medina. Each one was given a little bit provision, some bali, some dates, some paneer cheese. Small bundle was made and each one was given. Allah's Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam inadvertently forgot to give one sahabi, Hudayr radiallahu anhu, his provisions. Jamaat was dispatched. The sahabi without any food, he starts walking. Arduous journey in the desert, what does he say? He looks towards the heavens, oh my Allah, your Nabi forgot. I did not ask also. Oh my Allah, you have not forgotten. You know my need. You know my faqr. You know my dependence. Subbuhun, Quddusun, La ilaha illallahul malikul haqqul mubeen. Saying this, he moves in the path of Allah. First temptation, we go towards haram. First juncture, no sabr. We're not prepared to bear the first obstacle that comes in front. That is why there is no jhan in the salah of the summa today. That is why there is no jhan in the dua of the summa today. When it is haram in every direction, how is there going to be taqat in the dua? Moving in the path of Allah, this call causes the arsh of Allah to shake. Jibreel is sent to Rasulullah ﷺ, you forgot to give Hudayr his food. Allah's Rasulullah ﷺ immediately dispatches the sahabi. Go to him, listen to what he says and report back to me. As he approaches him, he can hear him saying, Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Oh my Allah, your Nabi forgot. I did not ask. You have not forgotten. Let your zikr be my food. When he gives it to him, Allah's Rasulullah is asking mazirat. He forgot. Jibreel was sent. Hudayr with tears in his eyes, he looks to the heavens. Alhamdulillah. Alladhi dhakarani min fawqi arshihi wa min fawqi sab'i samawatihi. Allahumma kama lam tansa Hudayr. فَجْعَلْ حُذَيْرًا لَا يَنْسَاكُ. Shukr to you, gratitude to you, my Mawla, my Allah, who remembered me from above his arsh, and who remembered me from above the seven heavens. Oh my Allah, just as you did not forget Hudayr, let it be such that Hudayr never ever forgets you. When the sahabi goes back to Rasulullah says to him, what did he say? He repeats these words. Allah's Rasulullah says, if only you could see the entire heavens and the earth were lit up with the nur of these kalimats. Why? That was the inner conviction, the inner yaqeen, the inner cry. Every Jummah khutbah, we are hearing it over and over again. Inna nasa lan tamuta hatta tastakmila rizqahu. Allah's Rasulullah challenges you on the authority of Allah. Khalik-e kainat, Malikul Muluk, Allah says, before you were created, I already decided what will reach you. You will not die. It is impossible. No accident will happen. No sickness will take you away. No disease will strike you. Nothing will happen to you. Your Allah's qasam, nothing will happen to you till you do not finish the rozi and sustenance which I have ordained for you. It will come to you. It will chase you. The choice is yours. Take it halal, we'll give it to you. Take it haram, we will give it to you. You will still get the same amount. You will not get more. But if you go towards haram, your dunya will be barbad. Your akhirat will be barbad. This yaqeen, this conviction, my respected brothers, has to be learned in the medan of yaqeen. Effort has to be made. We have to come into the correct environment. Environment of qurbani and sacrifice to erode all that mail and that incorrect awaz of batil that is reaching us in every direction. Allah Ta'ala give us tawfiq wa afiyat.